Now see, we have already talked that there are two types of IDD users. One is IntelliJ IDEA. This is paid what we call as community edition I am using. And another is your Eclipse. So both are there. People in industry both are using these two types of IDs. Majorly people are going for Eclipse. But whenever you are handling Eclipse, you will find there are no additional features being provided. So you have to do something manually. Apart from that, when you go for IntelliJ IDEA, this is an IDE where you can get very systematic information of what you are doing exactly, and it give alternatives for implementing executing the same program.
One second. It is a bit slow.
So whenever this you are creating a new project, automatically it will be extracting some libraries. So this library is nothing but your Java C and Java compiler interpreter all will be added over here. So you will find this extension. This is all libraries, whichever package you are using, that is you are importing any package, it will be directly imported from this package itself. So that is external libraries which are required for execution. So we have stopped here a few minutes before. That is a book. We'll be adding a whole object into a linked list, just like an array list. So here what we have done is that created a class book with the constructor, and we have passed five different values to that local variable of that book class. And now I am using creating object of book class with b1 with some different values, same way with book 2, that is b2 object, b3 object. And now I am not adding an integer, string, character, but here I am adding a whole object over here. So whole object will be added into your linked list, and it can be retrieved directly. But for the purpose of retrieving, we have to use this separate for loop. This is called an enhanced for loop. I think so. We have gone into detail. So we are creating a list. And what is list? List is nothing but an object of your linked list. So linked list is transferred into B. And what is this B? B is nothing but a class. So we are accessing directly that object. So b.id, name, author, publisher, all information will be retrieved and will be displayed in front of you. It is compiling now. It is running somewhat different program. Just 2 seconds. थोड़ा स्लो हो रहा है पीसी में, कुछ समझ में नहीं आ रहा। It's compiling. Now all these three records will be displayed with the help of this linked list, and we are using a special loop called as an enhanced for loop for displaying the content on a screen. Just like array list, we have given an example on the same. little bit, we'll move for the peak corners. See, the output is like this. So, just like the previous example, that is whole information will be displayed in the format of linked list. We are accessing the object of the book class by B, and we are retrieving its values of that element directly by using B.id, B.name, B.author, B.publication, publisher, and quantity. All will be retrieved just like an array list in a linked list. Now we'll move further for the peak function. So peak function, what we have talked is that we will be creating a linked list of peak. And now what we'll be doing, we'll be adding different. So I am not specifying that it is an array of string or array of integers. So it is a combination of string and number. So I am not given a bracket here specifying that it is a string. So it will be containing all values like in string and integer. Now I am displaying that string with list, and now I am using this peak. So what it will do is that the linked list will be displayed, and with the peak function will be displaying now the first element of your array list. So by using a peak function, you can check the first element of your array list. So using add first, add last, add first will be adding element at the first node. It will be creating a first node of your array list. Here, if you want to retrieve the first element, you will be using the function called as a peak. So only peak function will be giving this first element, that is your Greek, this is the index number 0 value, will be displayed. So peak is nothing but retrieving the value. Now what is exactly a peak? See, this method retrieves but does not remove the head first element of the list. So how this first element is not removed, we will check again by displaying this content at the bottom. So we will go into detail and we will check what is exactly this, it is removed or not. So we'll run this program same. Peak will be accessing the value, but we will never remove that value. But when you go for that pull, if you are using a pull function, it will be retrieved, it will be displayed, but it will be removed automatically from the first location. So it will be removed directly. So we'll get the same output just like that. In the previous, that is initial how you have created list, same it will be displayed here at the bottom. See, same output you are getting because it is only referring. But if I am using pool, same program. If I am using same program with pool function, P-O-L-L, pool function. Now what it will do is that, just like push peak function, it will be accessing the value. But here it will be access, and again it will be removing that first value from this one. So this is nothing but your first element. This is the concept of stack, that is the first element will be automatically will be retrieved and will be deleted automatically by using a pull function. Same way when you go for peak, another example, that is peak first, same program with we are using another type, that is peak first. And if you run this program, you will find